Hello friends, welcome to Friend of Health. In this episode, we are trying to discuss a method by which you can master H.C. Allen's keynotes in 44 days. We are expecting All India Ayush Postgraduate Entrance Test 2020 within 1.5 or 2 months. So, for those who have not started their preparation seriously, or those who are confused how to start, or who are having a starting trouble, or who are not aware how to study Allen's keynote, they will be benefited by watching this video. So please watch this video till the end and give your valuable suggestions, feedbacks and comments in the comment box below. If any of our viewer is feeling that you have a better method than the method we are saying in this video, please feel free to comment in the comment box below so that it will benefit the homeopathic students who are preparing for various competitive examinations in homeopathy. Because Allen's keynote is one of the very important area in any homeopathic competitive examination. May it be UPSC, state PSC examinations or lecture post PSCs or All India Ayush Postgraduate examination. A major share of question, mostly around an average if you see, around 10% of questions will be from Allen's keynote. Most of the time, sometimes it can happen like more than 10% can come from Allen's keynote area. So one should be thorough if they are seriously approaching the competitive examination in homeopathy. As I mentioned earlier, some are having a starting trouble or some are having a confusion how to study or how to finish this book, how to complete this Allen's keynote before the exam comes. So friends, if you have not started with your Allen's keynote seriously, or if you have started from the alphabet A or alphabet Z from the back and you are not able to finish it or you are not able to move forward, please watch this video till the end and try to study in this method. So before going into the video, let me say two proverbs. This is especially for those who are feeling that they cannot finish Allen's keynote before the exam comes, or they are feeling like they are not able to study Allen's keynote properly, or they think that even if they waste a lot of time on this, they won't be able to remember. For them, we are saying two proverbs: better late than never. So let it be late, but it's better always let it happen. So do it. Start studying the Allen's keynote from tomorrow. And one more similar proverb which I want to tell you people is, something is better than nothing. So something if you try, something if you study, that is better than nothing. So don't leave Allen's keynote aside and don't think that by doing, working out some questions, some previous questions on Allen's keynote, you can answer all the questions in the coming exam. You need to study it thoroughly, each word or each line of the Allen's keynote, because it is very important, and around 10% questions in most of the competitive examinations in homeopathy comes from Allen's keynotes. So our topic is how to master Allen's keynotes in 44 days. So before start studying the Allen's keynote or planning all these, you have to go through previous question papers of All India Ayush Postgraduate Entrance Test, that is 2017, 18 and 19, and also previous MD examination question papers from West Bengal University, Delhi University and Kerala MD Entrance. So this will help you what are the areas or how are the patterns of questions which are asked from the Allen's keynotes. Also, if you are preparing for UPSC, you have to go through previous UPSC question papers, so that you can understand the way the questions are framed in UPSC examinations. Homeopathic students are using different types of Allen's keynotes. Some are rearranged and classified. Some are not rearranged, but they will be having the Allen's keynote in the way how H.C. Allen has written. Both are equally good, but some find it easy with rearranged and classified book. Some find it easy with the not rearranged one. And nowadays, we have one more version with repertorial index, where each regionals like mind, vertigo, head, all the regionals are together given in a repertory type. So the students can easily memorize or compare different drugs at a single place under the regional heading. Most of the students are using this Allen's keynote. Allen's keynotes rearranged and classified. We'll see how the medicines are presented in this version of the Allen's keynote. We have Abrotanum to Zingum Metallicum in Allen's keynote to study. In this rearranged and classified version of Allen's keynote, we have the name of the remedy on the top and common name on the left side of the page and family or chemical name on the right top, constitution, etiology or causative factors, Mendel generals, physical generals, regionals, that means sometimes head will be given, eyes will be given, vertigo will be given, extremities will be given, skin, like that, different nervous system, locomotor system. So different regionals are given in this rearranged and classified version of Allen's keynote, and modalities is given separately, and the relationship of the remedy. This way, the drugs are, each medicine are presented in this rearranged and classified version of Allen's keynote. So this version of Allen's keynote makes it easier for the students while preparing for competitive examination purpose. Total number of medicines in Allen's keynotes is 187. So when we count in the book version, we can get 187 medicines. But in some websites like Vitolka's Academy, International Academy of Classical Homeopathy, if you see, 184 remedies are given. And if you see websites like homeoint.org, there only 185 medicines are given. So we have 187 medicines in the rearranged and classified version of Allen's keynotes. So for planning the study, planning our preparation in 44 days, we have taken it as an approximately 190 for easy calculation purpose, 190 medicines. So we will see why 44 days comes. We will see the calculation. We have told you in 44 days we can master Allen's keynote by this method. We will see the calculation details. We are planning to study 5 medicines in a day. So in a week, that is 7 days, 35 medicines. So 35 medicines in 7 days. And 35 medicines in a week. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks, we are covering this many 175 medicines. And in 3 days, five medicines, we are covering 15 medicines. So 190 medicines we are covering in 5 weeks and 3 days. Okay, so that means 5 weeks and 3 days means 38 days. So in 38 days we can cover the 190. But why 44? So 6 days we are keeping for revision in between. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So after each 35 days we will be doing a revision. So 6 days are for revision. So that means 38 plus 6, 44 days. You have to work on it. This is a calculation of 44 days. We will see it in detail. So don't think about big numbers now, like 187 drugs are there or 190 drugs are there and 44 days are there, 44 days are standing in front of me. Don't think those big numbers. Don't even think 35, like in a week 35 medicines will come. You think only the 5, this last 5 should be in your mind, so that every day you will be thinking about only 5 medicines every day, and that will be the main thing or main focus you have to do in this method. So this 5 you have to focus. So our study plan in detail, if you see the timeline, first day we are studying 5 medicines, second day again 5 medicines. Before going to the third day, second day night or second day when it ends, we are going to revise the first day and second day medicines. That is revision of 10 medicines of the day 1 and day 2. So day 1, 5 medicines you are studying, may let it be 2 hours time, you are completing 5 medicines. We will see in detail how to study these 5 medicines in a day. So before that, let me see the study plan timeline. So day 1, 5 medicines you are studying, day 2, 5 medicines you are studying, day 2 end or day 2 bedtime, you are going to revise the 10 medicines of day 1 and day 2. And the third day again 5 medicines, and fourth day again 5 medicines, and fourth day again revision of the 10 medicines only, not the 20 medicines. Okay, so this you have to focus. Don't take a big load on your head now. You just focus on the 10 drugs which you have studied on the third day and the fourth day, so that revision of 10 medicines of day 3 and day 4 will be done. Okay, so again fifth day 5 medicines and sixth day 5 medicines. So again on the sixth day night or sixth day ending time, you have to revise the 10 medicines, that is fifth days and sixth days, 5 medicines, 10 medicines of the day 5 and day 6 you are going to revise. And the seventh day you are studying again 5 medicines, and 8th day there will be a master revision or weekly revision of these 35 medicines. So day 1 to day 7 you have studied 35 medicines, and these 35 medicines you will be studying on the, you will be revising on the day 8. Don't think that you have to read all these 35 medicines on the day 8. You will be reading only the highlighted portions or only the areas which you will be feeling that it is very important. So we have seen in the timeline and the calculation session how to divide medicines in Allen's keynote to study easily in a 44 days time. So let us see in detail how to divide the medicines in the Allen's keynote for these 5 medicines per day. So if you see the list, Abrotanum to Zingum Metallicum, 187 medicines are there in the Allen's keynotes. 187 medicines in the Allen's keynotes. Some are having a habit of studying from A to Z. So sometimes they will finish it but they cannot remember, or they cannot recall, or they will be confused when they see the options. Or some will be having a problem of not completing the study. Like they will start with A, they will reach the C and they will stop the study. They will feel fed up, or they will think that okay, I cannot remember this. I am not able to recall when I am trying with some question papers. So let me do only question papers. I am not going to study the medicines. So that's why we have discussing this method with you, so that you can keep the spirit and keep the interest of studying these 35 medicines in a week, and this within these 44 days you will be completing the 190 medicines. We will see how to do that. We will be picking randomly 5 medicines from this list and we will be writing in different papers. So first what you have to do is you have to take a piece of paper or you have to start a word file and you have to write down all the names of all medicines from A to Z in the alphabetical order. So Abrotanum to Zingum Metallicum you have to list down in a one file, and different file you have to open or different paper you have to take and you have to write down in this way. Like this is one method. You can modify or you can do in a better way, and if you feel if you feel that a better method is there, please feel free to comment in under this video so that other students also will be benefited. So this way we have made this, like if you are starting from tomorrow, like 28/5/2020, see day 1, 28/5/2020, name of the medicine, common name, family, prover and parts used. We don't have the informations like prover or parts used in the Allen's keynote. We will be getting only common name and family. Sometimes we will be getting only one common name from Allen's keynote, most of the times. So we have to search in Boric or Clark's Materia Medica, so that Clark's dictionary, so that you can get another common name which may be asked in the competitive examinations. So from Clark's Materia Medica introduction part itself, you can get the prover name and the parts used most of the times. So it will help you in even answering some questions from the pharmacy part also. So it's better to do this way. At least you have to do common name, family and name of the medicine. So list down the medicines in a random way. Pick up from the other file or other piece of paper. Like if you are selecting Abrotanum, write down here Abrotanum. Then again you are going back to some other remedy like Calendula. So you can copy here Calendula. Then again you are going to some medicine from Hepaself. So this is we are randomly picking it so that it will be easy to memorize, otherwise you will be confused. So maybe Lachesis. So Plumbum Metallicum. So we have selected 5 medicines. 5 medicines randomly. Same way you have to do this, and whenever you are selecting you tick it here so that you won't do it 2 times. So after finishing 187 medicines in a, after selecting the 187 medicines in a random way and writing down in this piece of paper or this file, you can start doing the common name and family and prover part. So this you do every day when you study. So 5 medicines you will be studying every day. So tomorrow you can start the studying with making these plans. So these 2 piece of papers or 2 files you have to make, and you have to randomly fill everything like 1 to 87 abrotanum to zingum metallicum, you have to plan it down, you have to write it down. Then every day when you start studying 5-5 medicines in detail, you can study the common name from the boric and Allen's keynote, and the family also will be there in the Allen's keynote, and prover and parts used you can select from the Clark's dictionary. So this you have to study every day when you study the 5 medicines. And remember, revision is a very important part of this method, otherwise you cannot recall at the time of examination. So every second day you have to revise the first and second day's medicines, that is 10 medicines. Then every week on the 8th day you have to revise the 35 medicines. If you know a better method to study Allen's keynote in a short time, that is maybe in a 2 months time or 45 days time, please feel free to comment under the video so that it will benefit the aspirants of AIA PGT 2020, which is expected to happen in the end of July or August. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe this channel and share with your friends.